This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
For a special reason, why it comes first in the Torah. Many, many good reasons. But the main reason we can say is when Hat Hinuch is quoting, the whole Torah depends on Pirah V'Rivya. If we have children, and they're going to have children, so the Torah has a continuation. But if the Torah, if we're not going to have children, and there is no continuation to the world, who is going to keep the Torah? Who is going to observe the Torah? Hashem didn't give the Torah to Malachi Asharet, to the angels. He gave it to human beings. So by fulfilling the mitzvah of Pirah V'Rivya, we are making sure the whole Torah is going to be fulfilled. The whole Ratzon of Hashem is going to be done right way if we doing mitzvah Pirah V'Rivya. So the Torah depends on mitzvah Pirah V'Rivya, and therefore it comes first in the Torah. But also, we all know the Gemara, but the Gemara says, "Emet David ba ad sheichlu neshamot shebeheder," which means, in Shamayim, there is a place called the Heder. And that's where the neshamot are. And Hashem creates a neshama, he puts it in a Heder, in this Heder. And Ben David, Mashiach, is not going to come until all these neshamot came to this world and fulfilled their mission. So, by us keeping the mitzvah Pirah V'Rivya, exercising the mitzvah Pirah V'Rivya, it's not just an individual responsibility for ourselves, we're doing what Hashem says to do, but also, as a Jewish nation, as a collective responsibility, we are making sure the Geulah is going to come faster and quicker, and Chas V'Shalom should not be delayed. Therefore, the Gemara says, a person who's not keeping the mitzvah Pirah V'Rivya is delaying the Geula, Ma'akevet HaGeula. Also, it's called Mema'et Et HaDemut. What is it, Mema'et Et HaDemut? Mema'et Et HaDemut, B'Tzelem Elohim Asa Et HaAdam. And Klal Yisrael as a nation are representing Hashem. So if we're missing some of Klal Yisrael, that's called Mema'et Et HaDemut. The Torah says also, Gorem LaShechina SheTistalek MiYisrael. What does it mean? Since the Shekhinah in a high level, Asherat HaShekhinah in a high level, takes place when we have 22,000 Jewish people in one place. Where do we see it? The Pasuk says, Shuvah Hashem Rivevot Alfei Yisrael. Rivevot, Mi'ot Rivevot, it's 20,000. Alafim, Mi'ot Alafim, it's 2,000. So 22,000, if you have 22,000 Jewish people in one place, you have a high level of Asherat HaShekhinah over there. Although, Kol Be'asara Shekhin Tasharia, everywhere you have 10 people from Klal Yisrael, it's already called Aida, and that's Asherat HaShekhinah. You can say Kaddish and Kedusha, but there are levels of Asherat HaShekhinah. For example, Bet Mikdash Sheni, second Bet HaMikdash, had a lower level of Asherat HaShekhinah than compared to first Bet HaMikdash. On the second Bet HaMikdash, we were missing the Aaron, Kruvim, Lachot HaBerit, Sefer Torah Sha'asa Moshe, Tzintzenet Haman. All this we didn't have on second Bet HaMikdash. The image of the fire on top of the Mizbeah on first Bet HaMikdash was the image of a lion. On the second Bet HaMikdash, the image of the fire was the image of a dog, showing that the level of Asherat HaShekhinah is lower than what used to be in first Bet HaMikdash. So we see, although, yeah, it's Bet HaMikdash, it's the house of Hashem, but even in Bet HaMikdash, there are different levels of Asherat HaShekhinah. Kal v'chomer, after the destruction of Bet HaMikdash, yes, we have a shvu'ah, me'olam lo zaz HaShekhinah mikotel ha-ma'aravi, Shekhinah is there in Kotel ha-ma'aravi, but obviously it's not in the same level as Bet HaMikdash used to be there. V'ashimoti et mikdashechem, af al pi shehem shomimim, b'kdushatam hem omdim, there's still kedusha in the place where Bet HaMikdash used to be, and therefore we're not allowed to go into the territory of Bet HaMikdash, in the Temple Mountain, Har HaBayit, we're not allowed to go in there. All of us are considered Temei Metim. We don't have Para Aduma. We don't have the red cow. We cannot pure ourselves from Tum'at Met. And therefore, a Temei Met who's going into the territory of Har HaBayit, the territory of Bet HaMikdash, is Hav Mita. So therefore, it's strictly Asur to go inside the territory of Bet HaMikdash. But although it's Kadosh, although there is a Shrat HaShekhinah over there, but not at the same level as used to be at time of Bet HaMikdash. So here's the same. Kol be'asara shechin tasharia. We have asharat shechina everywhere. We have 10 people, 10 Jewish people in one place. It's already the asharat shechina. But if you have 22,000 people together in one place, that's a much higher level of asharat shechina. And therefore, imagine, says the Gemara, there are $22,000 minus one person. And why this person did not appear? It wasn't there because his father didn't do piravi revia. He was supposed to be there, but his father didn't. He was schlepping about it, and he didn't do piravi revia. And the reason is missing. He's not there. So who's gorem for the shechina to be mistalek? This person who didn't do mitzvah piravi revia. So here we see how strict, how important, and how what extent this mitzvah piravi revia is getting. It's not just one mitzvah of the Tariag mitzvot. It is one of the most important mitzvot in the Torah. Therefore, it comes first on the list. When the Torah starts to tell us the description of the creation, Bereshit bara Elokim et hashamayim et haaretz, the first commands of Hashem to Adam HaRishon, what is this? Piru uvu, milu et haaretz v'chivshua. That's the mitzvah, pira v'revia. So we will talk about this mitzvah a little bit. We'll try to understand this mitzvah. We'll try to find some hidushim also, things that related to these generations. But first, we'll see what's the hayuv, what's the obligation, what is it pirav revia, what do we have to do? So this is a machloket in the Mishnah and Yevamot between Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel. Beit Shammai says, if you have two boys, you fulfill the mitzvah. Beit Hillel says, it's not enough to have two boys, you got to have a boy and a girl. You got to have a male and a female. If you have a boy and a girl, you fulfill the mitzvah of Pirei V'Rivia. And Halacha Kebet Hillel, as we know. Beit Shammai Beit Hillel, Halacha Kebet Hillel. That's what the Rambam is Paskin, Shulchan Aruch Pasek. Eno Mekayim Mitzvah Pirei V'Rivia, Ad Sheyeh Lo Ben Uvat, Shnehem. We got to have a boy and a girl. Even if a person had 10 boys, and he didn't have a girl, he did not fulfill his hayuv of Mitzvah Pirei V'Rivia. Also the opposite, if he had 10 girls and he didn't have a boy, he did not fulfill the hayur of mitzvah pirav erbiyah. So we got to have a boy and a girl in order to fulfill this mitzvah. But also, even after a person had a boy and a girl, he's not excluded completely from the mitzvah. There's no vacation. They can say, oh, I did my duty, I have a boy and I have a girl, and I can go to sleep, I can go relax a little bit, I don't want any more children. The pasuk says, לבוקר זה רע זרעיך, ולערב אל תנח ידיך. So the Gemara, היו לו ילדים בבקרותו, בצעירותו, when he was young, he had children, יהיו לו ילדים בזקנותו. Even if he's an old man, he still should have more children. Why? The pasuk continues. The pasuk says, כי לא תדע איזה מהם יכשר, הזה או זה, אם שניהם כאחד טובים, you never know, who's going to be better? Who's going to be more successful? Who's going to succeed? The first one, the second one, or maybe both of them. So therefore, לבוקר זה רע זרעיך, ולערב אתה נח ידיך. So though a person fulfilled the mitzvah, the duty, he has a boy and a girl, and the mandatory, the basic mitzvah he did, but still, got to do לערב אתה נח ידיך, that's the continuation of the mitzvah. As we said before, by bringing more children to the world, we're making sure the Geulah is going to be faster. So, of course, that's part of it. Meshchei Shechina b'Yisrael, gorem la Geulah shetavo maher yoter. And therefore, this is a still going on obligation. Now, we'll try to understand how exactly this mitzvah is done. Or maybe we should ask ourselves like this. Is the mitzvah depends on a ma'aseh, there is any act that the mitzvah depends on, or the mitzvah is the reality? What does it mean? If a person have a boy and a girl, does he fulfill the mitzvah in any case? Or maybe there is a t'nai over here. What's the t'nai? You gotta have a ma'aseh, ma'aseh bi'ah. If there is ma'aseh bi'ah, then it's called that he fulfilled the mitzvah. But if he had a boy and a girl and he didn't do ma'aseh bi'ah, so he did not fulfill the mitzvah. And we'll try to explain it a little more. Yes, there's a Gemara in Hagigah, Daf Tetvav. The Gemara brings a situation over there where a woman got pregnant from a hat bat. What happened? Someone else was there before, and the zera in the water now. And now she goes after it, and she washing this water, and the zera goes to her uterus, and she gets pregnant. Is this make her? A few questions you can ask if he's a mamzer or not mamzer. That's one of the questions you can ask. But you can ask yourself. You can ask yourself also if is this person? Let's say it's her husband. Where she went to the bath in the house, and who was there in the bath before? Her husband. So now she got pregnant from her husband. So they fulfilled mitzvah piravi reviyah this way. They had a boy, or they had a girl. They fulfilled the mitzvah piravi reviyah. Or in order to fulfill the mitzvah, you got to do maaseh. You got to do derech eretz, what the Torah says to do. Mitzvah onah. He does what the Torah tells him to do, and by doing mitzvah biyah, he fulfilled the mitzvah. Good question. Mitzvot zerichot kavana. If a person did the mitzvah without a kavana, when a hatan is getting married, usually we tell him, now you're getting married, you should have a kavana to be yotze de chova. What mitzvah? You're doing mitzvah now. Mitzvah ta'ase min ha-Torah, ki yikah hishisha. You do mitzvah ta'ase. Mitzvah ta'ase laset isha. That's on the list of tayag mitzvot. 613 mitzvot include the mitzvah to get married. That's one of the mitzvot on the list. So by getting married, you are fulfilling mitzvah ta'aseh min ha-Torah. Why are we telling it to him under the chuppah? Because if he gets married and he doesn't have a kavanah to do a mitzvah, according to the poskim who says that mitzvot zerichot kavanah, which is the halakha, or so Shulchan Aruch is posek, mitzvot zerichot kavanah, we got to have a kavanah when we do a mitzvah, we sit in a sukkah. If a person sits in a sukkah, because everybody else is sitting in a sukkah, he doesn't have a kavanah to sit in to do a mitzvah, or it's a nice weather, he says, why should I sit inside? It's a nice weather outside. I'm going to sit in the sukkah. He sits for the other purpose, not for the purpose of a mitzvah. So he's losing the mitzvah. Mitzvot tzirchot kavanah. If he took the lulav with other kavanah to do the mitzvah, he's not yotzei ide chova. You got to do a kavanah. I'm taking this lulav. Why am I taking this lulav? I'm taking this lulav to do mitzvah. I'm putting tefillin. Mitzvot ta'aseh min ha-Torah. I'm wearing tzitzit. Mitzvot ta'aseh. Mitzvot tzirchot kavanah. So mitzvot piravi reviyah also. If it depends on the ma'aseh, I got to have a kavanah. When I go to do the ma'aseh of onah, I got to have a kavanah. I'm mechaven to do mitzvah ta'aseh min ha-Torah. Or maybe I don't care about the ma'aseh. I care about the tocha'ah, the result. How do I do mitzvah piravi reviyah? By actually having in the end the boy and the girl. What's the difference how they came to the world? They came to the world. They came to the world, have a boy and a girl. I did the mitzvah. If I had a kavanah or I didn't have a kavanah, it's not related. That's the question. If it depends on the ma'aseh, my ma'aseh is important here, and that is the mitzvah. Gufa mitzvah. What's the mitzvah of the Torah? To do ma'aseh. So I got to have my kavanah, and I got to have the ma'aseh. If I don't have the ma'aseh, I don't have the mitzvah. If I don't have the kavanah, I don't have the mitzvah. We'll try to get some examples to see from the halakha, from the Gemara, if it depends on the ma'aseh or not. We'll take it step by step. There is a halakha, interesting halakha, very interesting halakha. Goy, non-Jew, had children before. He had children when he was a goy. He had children. And then he converted, became Jewish. Does he fulfill the mitzvah? Did he fulfill the mitzvah of piravi reviyah by having a boy and a girl when he was a goy? So that's a discussion in the Gemara, Masechet Yevamot Bedaf Mem Zayin, Masechet Yevamot Bedaf Samech Bet, Masechet Bechorot Bedaf Mem Zayin. Machloket Resh Lakish Rabbi Yohanan. Resh Lakish says he did not fulfill the mitzvah. By having children when he was a goy, he did not fulfill the mitzvah. Why? Ger shenitgayar kekatan shenolad dameh. When a ger is converted, when a girl is converted, it's considered like a newborn. Whatever happened before is not related to after he was converted. Before he was called Mustafa, now he's called Abraham. Where's Mustafa? Mustafa died. And who's in the world now? There's a new person now. Abraham is a new person. So we don't care about what happened before. We care about what's happening now. What he had before, a boy and a girl, is not related to what's happening now. This is the opinion of Reish Lakish. But Rabbi Yohanan disagrees with Reish Lakish. Rabbi Yohanan says, "Hayu lo banim begiyuto, הרי זה קיים מצוות פירה ורבייה." רבי יוחנן says, "He fulfilled the מצוות פירה ורבייה." Why we don't say, "גר שנתגרה כקטן שנולד דמה over here"? Since a goy also has an obligation to deal with פירה ורבייה. Hashem Yitzbarach created the world to be continue. Hashem wants the world to be exist. Not just Jewish people. Hashem created Chinese people as well. Americans. Japanese. All kinds, Russians. Hashem created people in the world, and he wants them to be there. If Hashem didn't want Goyim to be in the world, so he would say, okay, I'll have only one nation. But Hashem created 70 nations, and we on Chag Sukkot, we served in Beit HaMikdash, 70 parim, keneged 70 umot. So there's a purpose for that. And Hashem wants them to be there. Lo tohu bera'ah, lashevet yetzara. Hashem wants the world to be, to exist, to keep going, to continue. That's Hashem's ratzon. So even a goy, when he's having children, he's fulfilling the ratzon of Hashem. He's shayach also in mitzvah of pirah, mitzvah pirah v'rivya. Shayach b'mitzvah pirah v'rivya. So the goy is also part of it. He's part of this mitzvah. Imagine if all the goyim will get together and they'll decide not to have children anymore. What's going to be in the world in the next 20, 25 years, 40 years, 50 years? What's going to be in the world in 50 years? It's going to be deserted. Nobody's going to be here. That's what Hashem wants. Hashem wants this world to be continued. So by them having children, they're also fulfilling the ratzon of Hashem. That's what Hashem really wants. So since the goy is shayach b'mitzvah pirah v'rivyah, even before he was mitgayer, so we are counting this as he did the mitzvah also after he was converted. That's Rabbi Yohanan's opinion. This is a mahloket. You know, usually, Rabbi Reish Lakish and Rabbi Yohanan, halacha ke Rabbi Yohanan. That's the normal rule in the Talmud, since Rabbi Yohanan was the Rabbi of Reish Lakish also. Halacha ke Rabbi Yohanan. But this is a mahloket, if we need them to be mitgayer also, he was converted, the father was converted, but the children, they were converted also, or they can stay goyim and fulfill the mitzvah. What are we talking about here? So Tosafot holds, even if they're goyim, he fulfilled the mitzvah. Still human beings in the world. He had a boy and he had a girl, two human beings in the world, and now, although he's a Yehudi and they're goyim, reality is that he had a male and a female in the world, and he fulfilled the mitzvah. Rambam says, no, it's not enough. They got to be also Jewish. Now he's a Yehudi, he has a Hiyuv. Now he has a Hiyuv to bring Jewish children to the world as a Yehudi. Once he became Yehudi himself, he has a new Hiyuv. What's the Hiyuv now? What's his obligation now? To have Jewish children. If a Yehudi is going to have non-Jewish children, did he fulfill mitzvah pirah v'rivyah this way? Of course not. If a Yehudi is going to go marry to a Goya or be with a Goya and have children from a Goya, even if he's going to have 100 children from Goyim, none of them is considered his son, and he did not fulfill himself whatsoever. None of them is considered his son even. Not just to fulfill the mitzvah, he did not, but also they're not considering his children. Yehus is only a Yehudi from Bat Israel. בנך הבא מן הנוכרית אינו קורא בנך סס דגמרה כי יסיר את בנך מאחריי. We learn from the פסוק. פסוק says כי יסיר את בנך. בנך הבא מביתך קורא בביתך שאינו בא מביתך אינו קורא בביתך אינו קורא בנך. If he came from, if this son came from a goya, he's not called your son. We learn from the פסוק, clear פסוק in the Torah. So therefore the obligation of a יהודי is to have Jewish children. Not enough to have people in the world. Got to be Jewish people. Got to have Jewish children. So the only reason why we're counting this goy as children although they were goyim, since he was a goy himself. He didn't have a chiyuv to have Yehudim. He was a goy. He had a chiyuv to have, in general, to have children. He had children as a goy. Now he became Yehudi. I'm not taking it away from him. I'm not taking the mitzvah that he did before and wiping it, erasing it. He still has the mitzvah, and I'm counting it for him. But Rambam says, although we're counting it for him, but now he's a new chiyuv. Now he's a Yehudi. What about the chiyuv of as of now? What he did before, we'll get the mitzvah for that. We'll get the sechar for that. But he's a new chiyuv now. As a Yehudi, he got to have Jewish children. So if they will be converted as well, if his son will convert and his daughter will convert, so I have now his children, two children, boy and a girl. Biologically, they are considered his children, and they are part of Klal Yisrael now. They converted, so we are considering it for him that he fulfilled the mitzvah. And that's the halakha. The halakha is כמו שיטת הרמב״ם, כך פוסק מרן בשולחן ערוך באבן עזר סימן א', that if a convert converted himself with his two children, a boy and a girl, he fulfilled the mitzvah of פירייה וריבייה. This is an interesting halakha. A little bit difficult to get the full definition of this halakha, because on one hand, we're not considering it for him, we're not considering them together as a family. A convert, even if the whole family converted, the father, the mother, the children, everyone converted, they're not considered related anymore. Halachically, they're not related. To that extent, that even is allowed to marry, Mina Torah, is allowed to marry his daughter. He's allowed to marry his sister. He's allowed to marry his mother, if she converted, and he converted, if both of them converted, they're not related anymore. She's not his mother, he's not her son, that's not her, she's his sister, he's not her brother. They're not related anymore. If two brothers converted together, they can be witnesses together. We cannot take two brothers as witnesses. Moshe Rabbeinu and Aaron HaKohen, together, they cannot be witnesses. Psulim Le'adut. Why? They were brothers. Moshe and Aaron, Ahim, right? They were brothers. Psulim Le'adut. If you would have Moshe and Aaron HaKohen, Moshe Rabbeinu and Aaron HaKohen, witnesses in your wedding, this Kiddushin is not a Kiddushin. Pasul. There is no Kiddushin there. Why? We've got to have witnesses by the Kiddushin. And they're not kosher for adult. The two brothers. I can have Moshe with someone else and Aaron with someone else, but I cannot have both of them together as witnesses. But if two converts, two goyim, they used to be brothers. When they were goyim, they have the same father, they have the same mother. They're brothers. Even for sure they're brothers. They're twins. They're twins. Shnei Ahim Teomim. Now we for sure have one father for them and one mother for them, right? Now it's clear. And they're converted after it. I can take them as two witnesses for the Chuppah and Kiddushin. Why? They're not brothers anymore. Biologically, yes, they came from the same father and the same mother. Genetically, they're called brothers. But halachically, they're not considered brothers. I can take them as witnesses. So on one hand, I say, Ger shenitgayar kekatan shenolad dame. He's like a newborn. I have two newborns here. They're not related. On the other hand, I say, no, he has two children, although he's allowed to marry this daughter, but still she's his daughter as regard as periyah v'reviyah. You understand? We're holding the rule from two ends, right? Now, what do we say? We say she is his daughter as far as Periyah v'Reviyah. We are considering it for him that he has a daughter. And we are considering them as not related now as far as getting married. That's a huge contradiction. That's a huge complication. How's that happening? But the truth is, there is different definitions in the Torah. Periyah v'Reviyah, we learn over here that the rule of Periyah v'Reviyah is not necessarily what we think Periyah v'Reviyah is. Rabbi Leviah is, if he did the mitzvah in reality, reality that's his boy, reality it's his girl, we are considering the mitzvah is fulfilled. Although halachically they're not related. It's not the terms and definitions of relations. And Yehus, whom is mityahes to whom, is not necessarily the same definition and regulations of the mitzvah of Rabbi Leviah. So we can learn the idea from this halacha that it's not depends on the ma'aseh of the person. The ma'aseh that he did before, what he did as a goy, is not related. The ma'aseh that he did, ma'aseh bi'ad that he did as a goy, is not counted as a Yehudi, what he did before. But I don't look at the ma'aseh. What do I look at? The bottom line, the tutsa'ah. Bottom line, the reality is that he has two children, he has a boy and a girl. That's fine with me. I consider it for him that he did it himself, Rabbi Leviah. I'll be more up to date now a little bit, and then we'll go back to the Gemara. This is what I said, this is halachot, Gemarot, but these days and age, many people who suffer from complications and they cannot have children in a regular way, so they go and do IVF. And that's done through, there's two kinds of complications. Sometimes, just the problem is the chick cannot get pregnant because of a medical issue that she has herself. The eggs are good, his zera is good, but she's not fertilizing on the right time or on the right schedule, or sometimes there is a complication, there is a clot on the tube, it doesn't come to the uterus, and therefore she cannot get pregnant normally. So what they do, they take the egg from the woman, and they take the zera from the man, they fertilize it in the lab, and then they're installing it back in the uterus, and she gets pregnant. So here's the father, she's the mother, they're a couple, they're married, everything is fine. Kosher, as far as the who's belonged to, everything is coming from the same parents. So we have the father, we have the mother, and now we have the baby. But they didn't do anything. The doctor came, took the zera from the man, then took the egg from the woman, and fertilized it in the lab, and put it back in the uterus. Is this considered his boy? Did he do mitzvah pi ravi raviyah? So what we learned now from the idea of a ger, that a ger fulfilled the mitzvah, although is not related to the ma'aseh that he did when he was a goy, it seems like also this couple doing the mitzvah pirav erevya. There's another complication that they don't need to take the egg out, just the zera of the man. Something is wrong with him, so they take it and they inject it to the uterus. This is a special way to do it, and she gets pregnant. He didn't do anything. The doctor did it. He has an injection through the uterus, straight to the uterus, and that's it. She gets pregnant. He went to sleep. The man was not there. He was not involved in the act of the mitzvah of Rabbi Leviah. But bottom line, 9 months later, they have a baby boy. They did the mitzvah of Rabbi Leviah or they didn't do the mitzvah of Rabbi Leviah? Not only the question if they did the mitzvah, but the question also is this boy is considered his son? That's his son? After he passed away, he is Yoresh? He gets the Yerusha afterwards? Or maybe it's not his son, since it wasn't done the right way, the regular way. It was done in a different way. What's the halakha in these questions? So we'll try to answer it with another Gemara Yerushalmi. Yes, Yerushalmi. The Yerushalmi says, Mamzer. Yerushalmi, Perek Bet, Yevamot, Halacha Vav, on the Mishnah, Bemasechet Yevamot, Bedaf Kaf Bet. Talmud Yerushalmi says, that Mamzer considered his son for Lechol Davar, even for Pirya Verivya. Mamzer, although it's a big issue in the Torah, Mamzer. Lo yavo Mamzer b'kahal Hashem. Mamzer cannot marry with a Jewish girl. But as far as the mitzvah of Pirah V'Reviyah, the father who brought this mamzer to the world, yeah, he is a boy now. He did something terrible, asur, but it's not covering, it's not shutting off the mitzvah. He did mitzvah Pirah V'Reviyah on one hand, and he did also isur. He did the kare, isur keretot. Either he went with a married woman, or he did with one of the relatives. So that is a terrible issue, but the bottom line that he has a boy, and it's against Ratzon Hashem, but the Gemara says, that's called Me'uvat lo yuchal itkon, ve'hisron lo yuchal imanot. That's a problem that you can't fix. One of the issues that you can't fix, that's a manzer. What are you going to do? How are you going to fix this? That's unreversible, this situation. But it's a boy, and it's his son. So, as far as mitzvah Pirah V'Reviyah, he did mitzvah Pirah V'Reviyah. That's what Yerushalmi says. Menhat Chinuch, b'mitzvah Aleph, is question here, big question. We have a rule, mitzvah haba'a ba'avera, according to many of the opinions, is not considered a mitzvah. What is this mitzvah haba'a ba'avera? Let's say, for an example, a person steals a lulav and a etrog on Hag Sukkot from someone to do the mitzvah. He steals it. He breaks to his house and takes the lulav and a etrog without of his permission. And he steals it. Not with the intention to return. He's not borrowing. He's stealing. Are you fulfilling the mitzvah of Pirah V'Reviyah now by stealing? That's called mitzvah. Yeah, the lulav etrog. But what's the mitzvah? The mitzvah is to take it, right? Mitzvah of the Torah is to take it. All the hakafot that we do, the halel and the na'anu'im, it's all in addition to the mitzvah. It's a hidur mitzvah. Mitzvah min avha, mitzvah drabanan. But the mitzvah of the Torah, what the Torah tells us to do? Ulkachtem lachem b'yom ha'rishon. By taking it, you're fulfilling the mitzvah. So by him stealing it, is at the same time taking it. He's stealing and taking. Did he fulfill the mitzvah of the Torah by taking it? He lifted to steal it. Did he fulfill the mitzvah? That's called mitzvah haba'a ba'avera. So many opinions, according to many of the poskim, the avera shuts off the mitzvah over here. Avera mechaba mitzvah in this case. The avera shuts off the mitzvah, it's not called a mitzvah. You cannot do a mitzvah at the same time by doing avera. So Minhat Chinuch is asking here a question. You're saying this mamzer, this guy brought a mamzer to the world, and you're telling me he fulfilled the mitzvah of Pirah V'Reviyah. How is it possible? This is mitzvah haba'a ba'avera. Avera of karet. One of the worst averot in the Torah. How did he fulfill the mitzvah Pirah V'Reviyah if he did avera at the same time? That's the question of Minhat Chinuch. And he answers a very interesting answer. He says, when is mitzvah haba'a ba'avera is not considered a mitzvah? That is only if at the same time the mitzvah and avera are coming at the same time, same act. Like this guy who was stealing the lulav. Same act of stealing is the act of the mitzvah. He stole the lulav, and at the same time he wants to do the mitzvah. That's called mitzvah haba'a ba'avera. B'sha'at ha-mitzvah hu oseh avera. At the same time it comes, they come together. But Pirah V'Reviyah, it's two separate times. He went and did a terrible avera and his hayav karet. 9 months later, he had a baby boy. When he fulfilled the mitzvah, he fulfilled the mitzvah when he had the boy. When the actual baby came to the world, then he fulfilled the mitzvah. By doing the act of the avera, you cannot take away the result what happened 9 months later. That's two separate times. That's two separate events. The event of the Avera took place at one time, and although, of course, the baby came from 9 months later from that Maaseh, but we cannot say that this mitzvah that came 9 months later is called Ba'a Ba'Avera. The Avera was in a separate time, separate event, and the mitzvah, it's a separate time and a separate event. And since the mitzvah and the Avera are two different events, that comes in two different times, therefore, it's not under the regular definition of mitzvah ba ba'avera, in such a case, the avera does not shut off the mitzvah. It stays a mitzvah. And we're considering it for him that he did a mitzvah pi avera. What do we learn from this minhat chinuch? What do we learn from this? That really the mitzvah is not the ma'aseh. We don't care about the ma'aseh so much. What do we care about? We care about the result, the bottom line. He has a child, 9 months later after the avera, and since it's a different, that's the ikar of the mitzvah. The mitzvah is not the ma'aseh, the mitzvah is the result, the metziut, that he has a boy. So therefore, it's not concerning mitzvah ba avera. Here we learn again that the mitzvah pirah v'riyah does not depend on the ma'aseh specifically. But we'll say that it's not so simple. That's Minhat Chinuch's opinion, but we will see that this is a huge mahloket. There is a Mishnah, Masechet Gittin. The Mishnah says, מי שחציו עבד וחציו בן חורין. Half a slave and half a free person. What does it mean? He used to be a slave. We're talking about Eved Kenani. He used to be a slave. And his master, his Adon, free him half. He freed half of him. He let him go free half, halfway. He told him, Hare ata ben horin, hitzicha. Half of you is ben horin. Okay, he's a half a slave and a half a free man now. What's his definition of halakha? Says Bet Hillel, עובד את רבו יום אחד ואת עצמו יום אחד. On Sunday he's working for his master, on Monday he goes to work for the pizza shop. He works for himself. He makes money for himself. One day for his master, one day for himself. Half a slave, half free. Comes בית שמע and says, hey, רבונו של עולם, תקנתם את רבו, אבל את עצמו לא תקנתם. You made a solution for his master that he is half and half now. But what's with this guy himself? He needs to get married, and now he cannot marry anyone. Lisa shifcha no yachol shechitzio ben chorin. He cannot marry a shifcha because he's a half free man. Half free man is mean he's half a Yehudi. Lisa bat chorinin no yachol shechitzio eved. He has the other half is eved. He cannot marry a bat Israel. Eved is not allowed to marry bat Israel. The Torah says lo yeh kadesh b'vnei Israel. What does it mean lo yeh kadesh? It means Eved is not allowed to marry a Jewish girl. What's called Eved Kenani in the Torah cannot marry a Jewish girl. That's lo yekadesh. So this is lo ta'aseh. So what should he do now? Lashevet batel, not to get married at all. The Torah says lo tov bira lashevet yitzara. You gotta get married. So what's the solution? Kofin et rabo v'chotev lo get shichrur. We are forcing his master to release him and to free him completely. Now he's going to have to pay him the money that he owes him. Now a slave has a value. Let's say a slave cost $100,000. He was half free, so his value is $50,000. He is writing a shtar chov to his master. He owes him $50,000. He's going to pay it to him slowly, slowly. But he got to free him. You can't hold him in such a situation. You can't hold him like hanging in the air. Not here, not there. Not Jewish, not a slave. In the middle. You cannot marry a slave, you cannot marry a Jewish girl. He's stuck. You can't keep him stuck. You have to have a solution for him. And since the only way to resolve this issue is to free him, so kofin et rabo, we're forcing him. Bedin, forcing the master, the Adon, to free this slave. Let him go free. And he's going to pay you the money later. Comes to Safot and asking a question. Why it's so complicated? We have a rule in the Torah. What's the rule? Aseh, dohe, lo ta'aseh. I'll give you an example. What's aseh, dohe, lo ta'aseh? Torah says, Hishamer benega tzara'at. We have to be very careful on the nega'im of tzara'at, the leprosy. By the way, we're learning from this pasuk also, not to speak lashon hara. What causes tzara'at? What causes leprosy? Speaking lashon hara, bad mouthing, that causes tzara'at. Zachor et asher asa Hashem Elohecha leMiriam. What Hashem did to Miriam? What happened to Miriam? She got a tzara'at. Why she got a tzara'at? Because she spoke about Moshe. Vatedaber Miriam b'Moshe. So Hishamer benega tzara'at. But besides of speaking lashon hara, the Torah talks about that a person is not allowed to cut off the leprosy. If a person has a tzaraat, you got to call the Kohen, and the Kohen has to tell him if he's a tameh or tahor, and there are rules and regulations what he's supposed to do. So what he wants to do, this guy wants to go, he's going to cut it off. Sometimes the size of their leprosy makes the difference. If it's the size of kagris or less than kagris. So he goes ahead and cuts it off. And now it's less than size and he's tahor. Is he allowed to do it? Comes the Torah and says, Hishamer benega atzarat. You can't touch it. Do not do it. Don't go to the doctor, do a surgery and take it off. You cannot. You got to go to the Kohen, and the Kohen is going to tell you, tahor, tameh, follow the instructions. Hishamer benega atzarat. Now, what if this tzaraat came on the baby? We have a baby. And the tzaraat is on the baby. Where? On the ola, where we're supposed to do the circumcision. On one hand, the Torah says, don't cut the tzaraat. On the other hand, the Torah says, uvayom shemini, imol besar olato, cut off this ola. Now comes the 8th day. What do I do? Do I do brit milah? I cut the orla, or I hold back and sit back and don't cut it because the Torah says, oh, the tzara'at there, you're not allowed to cut the tzara'at. What's the halacha? Aseh, doheh, lo ta'aseh. That's the halacha. Uvayom ha'shimi, what is this mitzvat? Mitzvat aseh. Imol, mitzvat aseh. Hishamer, hishamer ne Torah, it's lo ta'aseh. We have ramah, aseh, shasa, lo ta'aseh, right? Taryag mitzvot, right? So this, berit milah, mitzvat aseh, and tzara'at, not to cut the tzara'at, it's lo ta'aseh, don't do. The rule is that aseh takes over the lo ta'aseh, and pushes off, and push it off. And therefore, dohe lo ta'aseh. Do brit milah, cut the orla, with the tzara'at, cut it off. That's the rule. So now, Tosfot is asking a question. You have an issue here, what's the issue? This half slave, half free man, right? He cannot marry to a Jewish girl. Why? Because they say, oh, he's a half slave. But he has mitzvat aseh. What's the mitzvat aseh? Biriyah v'riviyah. Lo yeh kadesh. What is it, lo yeh kadesh? It's lo ta'aseh. And biriyah v'riviyah, what is it? Mitzvat aseh. Yavo aseh v'itchel lo ta'aseh. That's the question of the Tosfot. Why do we forcing his master to free him? Let him get married the way he is. Keep him the way he is. Let him get married. Aseh doheh lo ta'aseh. That's the question of Tosfot. And Tosfot answers. Tosfot answers. When do we say aseh doheh lo ta'aseh? It's similar to what Ibn Hat Hinuch says, just in a different version. When aseh doheh lo ta'aseh, when they come together, at the same time they come together. Like berit milah and the ola, same act, same cut, does both. I cut the ola and I cut the tzara'at at the same time. It's not two different acts. It's one act. But here, the isur of lo yekadesh begins from, it's called ha'ara'a. Ha'ara'a means, even if he did not do the full bi'ah, just the beginning of the bi'ah, achnasat ha'atara, that itself caused already the isur of lo yekadesh. And when he fulfilled the mitzvah of piriyah v'riviyah, only by the end of the bi'ah. Listen to the Tosfot. It's different than Minhat Hinuch. Minhat Hinuch says, when he fulfilled piriyah v'riviyah, 9 months later when he's having a baby. Tosfot says, when he fulfilled mitzvat piriyah v'riviyah, by the end of the bi'ah. The Isur is in the beginning of the bi'ah, and the mitzvah is in the end of the bi'ah. So what do we learn from Tosfot here? The ma'aseh is the mitzvah. And if Minhat Hinuch is right, and the Ma'aseh is not related to the mitzvah, the question of Tosfot does not start, does not begin, the question does not begin. What's the question? Aseh, dohe lo ta'aseh. There is no Aseh here. What's the Aseh? The Aseh is to have the baby. I don't care about the Ma'aseh. So you cannot put this under the category of Aseh, dohe lo ta'aseh.
They're not getting married.
So,
They're not getting married?
They're getting married.
Because there's another Aseh to get married, but there's Aseh before.
Lo yekadesh is not to get married. It's not to
there's
not to do.
To get married, I've said before.
Oh, yeah, this is separate. I said the question is another question: if kiddushin tofsimba, lot of simba kiddushin, if kiddushin is taking place in such a situation, half a avid, this kiddushin to such a situation, that's not a discussion on Tosfot. But it's off topic. I don't want to get in this. It's going to take us a long time now. And just what related to Priya v'Revya, we learn from this Tosfot that Tosfot considered the ma'ase of bi'ah the ma'ase of the mitzvah. That's what we learn from the Tosfot. And this Tosfot comes 3 or 4 times in the Shas. Yesh Tosfot kaze. I tell you where you can look at it later. Tosfot says, Tosfot talks about it, Masechet Chagiga Daf Bet Amud Bet. Same Svarah that Tosfot says over there. Also Tosfot says it in Masechet Bava Batra Daf Yud Gimel Amud Bet. Also Tosfot says it in Masechet Yevamot Daf Samech Bet. And also Masechet Pesachim Daf Mem Chet. 4 places. Masechet Pesachim, Tosfot says that the end of the Bi'ah, meaning when the Zerah comes out, that's the mitzvah. Okay? But it's Ma'aseh Bi'ah. There is a Ma'aseh Bi'ah over here. So 4 times in the Shas, Tosfot says this idea, that the Ma'aseh of Bi'ah itself, that's called Piriyah v'Riviyah. That's what Piriyah is. Of course, the mitzvah is not completed until actual baby is going to come to the world, but what do we call a mitzvah? We call a mitzvah the Ma'aseh of Bi'ah. So according to this opinion, according to the Tosfot, if he didn't do Ma'aseh Bi'ah itself, although he had a child in the end of the story, that's not his mitzvah. It could be that's his son. I'm not saying he's not his son. Will be considered his son. But is this man getting a sachar that he did mitzvah Piriyah v'Riviyah? Or the question is, does he have to get married now to do mitzvah Piriyah v'Riviyah, or he already did it in his patur? According to the Tosfot, if he had a child and he didn't do the mitzvah of Bi'ah, he didn't fulfill the mitzvah. He got to get married again and he got to have more children. The fact that he has a child, and it's not poter him from the mitzvah, since the mitzvah is involved with the ma'aseh and he was not part of the ma'aseh. So according to the Tosfot, the IVF, although it's his son, but it's not a mitzvah. And now we have, not just Tosfot says that, we have, I told you the Yerushalmi says that if he had a mamzer, that's called that he did mitzvah Piriyah v'Riviyah. But interestingly, Harambam is not quoting this Yerushalmi, ignoring this Yerushalmi. Harif is ignoring this Yerushalmi. Harosh is ignoring this Yerushalmi. Usually, if there is a halakha in Yerushalmi, even though it wasn't brought in the Talmud Bavli, but Harambam is bringing it. Talmud Yerushalmi is part of the Torah. So Rambam gets the halachot from everywhere, from Bavli, from Yerushalmi, from Sifra, Sifri, Mechilta, from everywhere. And here Rambam is ignoring this halacha. Rambam never ignore halacha unless if he doesn't think that's the halacha. A question: why Rambam ignores it? Why he didn't bring it to his sefer? Why Harif did not bring this halacha? Why Harosh didn't bring Shlosha Amudei Hora'a? Those are the 3 pillars of Hora'a in the halacha. When we Maran Shulchan Aruch is pasking halacha, he follows these 3 leaders in halakha, these 3 great poskim. They're called Amudei Hora'a, the pillars of Hora'a. Arambam, Arif, Arambam, Ve'arosh. And all 3 of them did not quote this Yerushalmi according to halakha. Halakha, lo kimo Yerushalmi hazeh. Omer HaMa'arit El Gazi, Ma'arit El Gazi, Rabbeinu Yom Tov El Gazi, he has a sefer Maser Bechorot, Daf Memchet over there, he says, the reason why all these 3 great leaders did not brought the Yerushalmi to halakha, because they hold it is considered mitzvah ba'a ba'avera. And if mitzvah ba'a ba'avera, if it's mitzvah ba'a ba'avera, it's not a mitzvah. If they hold it's mitzvah ba'a ba'avera, what does it mean? That ba'avera and the mitzvah is done at the same time. Which means the mitzvah is not just the result, it is also the ma'aseh. So now we have not only Tosfot, we have Arif, Arambam, Arosh, and Tosfot in 4 places in the Shas. All of this poskim holds that if he didn't do the ma'aseh of Bi'ah, he did not fulfill the mitzvah of Piriyah v'Riviyah. So, of course, if a couple will come over to us and they're going to ask us the question as follows. Doctor says they cannot have children in a regular way. The only way they can have children is through IVF. Should they do it or shouldn't they do it? The answer is, It's a big machloket if they're fulfilling the mitzvah of Pira v'Revia. We don't have to tell them all this negotiation, but it's a machloket. But in the end of the day, according to Minhat Chinuch, it is a mitzvah. It is a mitzvah. Also, there is a Bet Shmuel who says it's a mitzvah. I'm going to tell you, I have 7 minutes to tell it to you. Bet Shmuel says, he's quoting Rabbeinu Peretz, בהגאות הסמק. Also, הבח מביא אותו ביורי דעה בסימן קוף צדיק ה', בית שמואל מביא אותו באבן עזר סימן א'. רבנו פרץ says as follow, a very interesting הלכה, very, this is like, you cannot imagine this, but this is what he says. He says, a woman is allowed to sleep on her husband's sheet. When he was sleeping in the sheet, she's allowed to sleep on the same sheet, even if she's an idah. And we don't care if she's going to get pregnant. But she should not sleep in a sheet if a strange man was sleeping on it. Why? Maybe he's going to get pregnant. So if we care about a strange man that she's not going to get pregnant like this, why we don't care if she's getting pregnant while she's an idah? If there is a boy from an idah, if there is a child coming from an idah, is this something simple? Is this less than a mamzer? Nidah is so terrible, Zohar says, if you have been an idah, if a man slept with his wife before she went to the mikveh, and she conceived, and she had a baby afterwards, this child is going to suffer his entire life. He has a tum'ah that is such a hard time to get rid of this tum'ah. Unless he's going to learn Torah. If he's going to learn Torah, the Torah has the power to purify him, to take away the tum'ah from him. But if he is not learning Torah, he's tamei his entire life. He cannot get rid of this tumah. But vatehi nidata alav. It's a terrible thing, nidah, ben alidah. So why we say we don't care? Of course we care. She shouldn't sleep on the sheet when she's an idah. So Rabbeinu Peretz explains. He says, no. If she's going to get pregnant this way, the child is not going to be considered ben alidah. Why? Was no ma'aseh. When he's called Ben Anida, when he actually did, he had a relationship with her, and he did Ma'aseh Bi'ah, when she's Anida, they did Isur Karet. Now this baby has the Pgam of Ben Anida. Although it's Kasher Lavo Baka, he's allowed to marry with a Jewish woman, but it's a terrible Pgam, as we explained before. But here, if she's going to get pregnant this way, that's not happening because of a Ma'aseh. They didn't do any Isur. There is no Isur Karet over here. There was no Bi'ah. They didn't have any relationship. She got conceived from the Zera on the sheet. Or in the water, in the Ambati, as we said before. So, it's not Ben Anida. So why do I care about a strange man? If it's not Ben Anida, it's not Mamzer. He says, Rabbeinu Peretz, yes, it's not Mamzer. It's not Mamzer. But maybe one day this man is going to marry his sister. If she got pregnant from a different man, she doesn't know it even. That's his son. Right? It's his son. If it's his son, and he has a girl, she's his sister. One day he goes out, he sees this girl, oh, wow. He feels connected to her. And he thinks, oh, he found his match. Love from first sight. And truly, she's his sister. So, to prevent something like this to happen, we don't want to have these complications. So therefore, women should be careful. That's what Rabbeinu Peretz says. Now, let's see what comes out of it. Rule number one, even if she was conceived with no ma'aseh bi'ah, it's called his son. Rule number two, it's not Ben Anida. Rule number three, it's not a mamzer. So in order to be a mamzer, gotta be such a terrible situation where the actual ma'aseh took place, but there was no ma'aseh, it's not a mamzer. Also, as far as Ben Anida, if it wasn't ma'aseh bi'ah, it's not Ben Anida. But it is his son, says Bet Shmuel. If it's his son, he did mitzvah pirah v'revia. So we see that it's not just Minhat Chinuch who says that he did Mitzvah Pirei Aveh this way, and it's not just coming out of the Adchav Gerut or Adchav Mamzer or Akonet Yerushalmi in Aritba, but Yosef Mevit Aritba Shemevit Yerushalmi Masbir Oto Kacha. It's not just that. We see also here. Bet Shmuel holds Akonet Rabbeinu Peretz. That's called Hesan, and he fulfilled Mitzvah Pirei Aveh Rivya. Therefore, when this couple comes to us and asks us this question, should they do it or shouldn't they do it? What's the advice would be? Yes, do it. Maybe they did not fulfill the mitzvah according to all the opinions. We can say even many of the opinions hold, of our greatest poskim holds, they did not fulfill the mitzvah pirei aveh rivya, but it's enough that they do fulfill the mitzvah pirei aveh rivya according to many of other opinions. On Shamayim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to decide halakha kemo mi. We don't need to decide here. But also, we're learning from Rabbeinu Peretz a big, huge halakha. And that is a complication that happens a lot. I've been asked this question over the years, maybe 5 or 6 times, and it's been brought also in Poskim beforehand. A woman whose her ovulation time takes place in the middle of the 7 clean days. Which means by the time she's going to go to the mikveh, she's not going to be able to conceive. You know what happens in such a situation? She can never get pregnant. Her ovulation is on the 2nd day of the 7 days. She has 5 more days to go before she's going to go to the mikveh. Doctor says there is no way to push it off. Sometimes with medications, they can play with this a little bit, try to work on her regulations, on a schedule, on a period schedule, and they can try to change it. Sometimes, it's impossible to change it. Or even after all the changes, they manage to push it off for 1 day or for 2 days, but still it comes 3 days before the mikveh. And that can last, the ovulation can last only for 3 days. If it's within 3 days to the ovulation, then she can be conceived. More than that, she cannot. They're married already for 10 years. They're heartbroken. They cry daily to Hashem to help him to help children. And halachically, they cannot have children because her ovulation time comes at the time when she's still asur for her husband. What do you tell these people? So of course, to tell them to do mikveh orli, we cannot make the mikveh orli, since it's a safek zavod deoraita. We cannot tell them to chas v'shalom to do a ma'aseh of karet bar minan. That's against the Torah. The only solution they have, what's the solution is? They have it's called external fertilization. The doctor is going to take the zera, and he's going to inject it to the uterus when she's ovulated. IVF, similar. Not with the egg, we don't need the egg here. The egg is, she has a good egg, everything is fine. Just the time schedule is not working out. So we learned from Rabbeinu Peretz that if it wasn't Ma'aseh Bi'ah, then what? It's not Ben Anidah. When is going to be Ben Anidah? All the whole problem of Ben Anidah is happening only if it was Bi'ah. But if it wasn't Bi'ah, it's not Ben Anidah. After they will do it, that will be considered his son? Yes, considered his son. Did they fulfill Mitzvah Pirei this way? Mahlokit. But is there any issur to do it? Why should we say there is issur? There's only one complication, but we're already behind time, so I'm just going to mention it. The maybe hashash that some of the poskim brought is issur zera levatala, but the answer for that is it's not levatala. He does it in order to get his wife pregnant. That goes straight to the uterus, and she's going to get pregnant. So why it's called levatala? It's not levatala.
She doesn't get pregnant, then it becomes
a... No, because every time, not every time a person does it in a regular way, she gets pregnant. So here it went to the right place in the end. She got pregnant or not, that's up to Hashem. But the intention was to have children, not Hasu Shalom Levatala. So the conclusion of the poskim is that it's permitted. And that's the advice we will give to this couple. If the ovulation time takes place doing the Shiva Nikim, and there is no other way to push it off, to reschedule, to change the schedule of the ovulation, that's the way to handle it, and that's the solution for this couple. And I can tell you for a few stories already that they did it, and Baruch Hashem, now they have children. And the child came to the world, Baruch Hashem, healthy and growing in yeshivot, and everything is beautiful. Not everybody knows how she got pregnant exactly, but yes, halachically it's permitted. That's one of the examples. The other example that we mentioned before, it's medical issues. If they have medical issues and they cannot get pregnant, so same idea. But here, we maybe will take it to a different class already. What if the woman has a problem with the eggs and she wants to have an egg from someone else, from a different woman? Is this something permitted or not? Is this something okay to do or not? It's not for one class, maybe. Maybe we can have a series of classes just to explain this. We'll see. I'm not guaranteeing that we're going to go in this direction, but we'll see. That's a topic. It's a heavy topic, heavy-duty topic. We can speak about it for hours and hours to analyze it and to find sources in Torah this way, the other way. Be'ezrat Hashem. But for this particular issue that we mentioned today, so the halakha is, yes, it's permitted to do it this way and the situation that we mentioned. It is considered his son as far as Yerusha, as far as Kibud Avaim, and other fathers and son regulations. But as far as Priya V'Revya, we learned it's a mahloket. But according to many of the opinions, they fulfilled mitzvah Priya V'Revya as well. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.